The recording is start. This is part of my money growing channel vlog, and yung gusto kong i-discuss sa topic na ito is why you should not borrow to invest. The number one thought is that why you should not borrow money to invest is because, number one, it's very high risk. So, kung titignan mo sa mundo natin, pag nag-start ka ng mangutang ka na, siguradong sunod-sunod na yun eh. Lulubog at lulubog ka dun sa point na kung saan walang-wala ka na sa buhay. And the fact that pag nangutang ka, borrowing money just to invest is a very critical or high-risk situation. So instead of building your wealth more, you'll end up in a situation that is highly volatile in terms of your wealth perspective, or kung saan, pag ikaw yung tao na bubuo ka ng wealth over time, borrowing money just to invest is a very high risk. So number two is that borrowing money to invest is you are paying more the interest instead of saving that interest to your future goal. Ang point ko sa number two is that instead of nanghiram ka ng pera para i-invest mo, kasi alam mo naman yung hiniram mo na pera, may interest yun at ibabalik mo yun sa bank anytime. Yun yung possible scenario na best na mangyayari. Pag nag-leverage ka ng investment, that's a probability of 50% chance you will win on leverage and 50% chance you will lose. But on the other hand, this is the most surely possible that will happen is that you will 100% pay on the money you have borrowed onto him. So instead of just saving that money, saving that interest over time, you could build more wealth than borrowing money just to invest and returning it to the borrower at the same time, which is likely not a good option for an investment strategy. Number three is that upon building wealth, you must maintain an income portfolio or an income flow. So when you started to loan, and for example, you have a loan on a government and you started to pay the government loan monthly basis, you reduce your income, you reduce the income flow in your asset portfolio or investment portfolio. So malaking effect ito sa in terms of expense mo, kasi pag nag-maintain lang yung level of expense mo na mataas, then binawasan mo yung flow ng income mo, lulubog ka dun sa point na malaki yung mawawala sa'yo, unless you have gained attraction to leverage what you have borrowed, which is still unpredictable. Number four is that growing your money takes time and patience. So kapag nangutang ka kasi nang nag-borrow ka ng money, instant money yun eh. Andyan na agad yung pera, andyan na agad yung ready-made ka. So, but you lose this kind of decision making on how to use this kind of money. So maraming magsasabi ng tao na gagamitin nila sa project, gagamitin nila sa kung saan gustong bilhin ng mga material na bagay na gusto nila, which is a bad option when it comes to building wealth. Kasi in terms of building wealth, money takes time. Takes time and patience. So in the long run, yung consistent flow na mas malaki yung income na pumapasok sa'yo monthly, mas advantage yun kesa dun sa na-reduce yung income na-reduce yung income flow mo in a monthly basis, which is you're not only paying the interest in return, you are paying also the whole capital in return, which is in the long run you will lose. Instead of just disregarding the loan, the borrowing type, then continuously gain that income, yung income na na-save mo, invest what you can only have to afford, or 20% of your income, monthly income, is pupunta sa investment. Unlike kasi kung pag naghiram ka agad ng automatic na pera, you have this big pile of money, big pile of cash, you started to have this confusion of you will have to invest it or not. Or you will have to invest, but you'll end up in a wrong investment option, which is much worse. You not only make that money go down, you still have to pay your borrower at the end, which is a double kill in your situation.
Double kill!
Number 5 is that very critical yung relationship mo sa borrower, which is you could end up in a bad relationship if you are unable to maintain a good credit score or good credit history. So kung first time mo namang hiram sa inutangan mo tapos pumalpak ka, hindi ka agad nakabayad, malaking issue na yun in terms of your relationship to that person. You may come to the point na iniiwasan mo na yung taong ito, or di kaya may something na parang maliit, lumiit yung mundo mo bigla dahil lang dun sa inutang mo na hinahirapan kang magbayad. Kasi you'll end up fail on your investment, because investment is a volatile or unpredictable market. So you'll end up on a bad position. 70% chance you'll end up on that bad position. So last but not the least is number 6. You'll end up depressed, broke, or even anxious. So based sa experience ko, naranasan ko yung experience na ito. Ito yung pinaka-worst siguro na nangyari. Pero hindi ko ma-blame kung dahil yun sa investment or wrong investment decision na nagawa ko nung 2019, which is kung sinong nakakaalam sa inyo nung nagpatok yung Kappa Investment or Almamico region. Lahat yan sumikat yan dito sa Mindanao, eh. Dito talaga mismo sa area namin. So by that moment of time, inexperienced pa ako in terms of investment, in terms of financial decision. Pero naakit ako dun sa recommendation ng mga tao na lahat na sila pumasok, eh. Kasi lahat naman nakakakuha, nakaka-receive. But I enter on a booming or likely to fail. Kumbaga, pumasok ako sa investment na yun na kung saan malapit nang sumabog. Which is nakakuha na yung mga nauna, then kami yung mga nasa huli. By that time, it was February, March, it was likely to collapse. So masasabi mong Ponzi scheme yung structure niya, eh. Kasi di mo rin naman mabiblame kasi donation yung nakalagay. Which is we donated our money for free. But all in our mind, all of the believers in Kappa at that time, we believe that it is a financial liberation. Which it falls in a false hope at the end. So sa mga kasagsagan ng mga investment scheme na yon na mga nangyari, syempre hindi rin ako nagpahuli nun. Kasi first is natemp akong naghulog ng mga nasa 30,000, my first investment, Kappa. Then time comes, nagkaroon na ako ng another financial, or nagkaroon na ako ng greed, na-develop yung greed sa mga time na yun ako saan parang hindi ka kontento sa 30,000. So my biggest bad decision by that time is grant a loan. Nag-loan ako in our office, in our agency, that I think 100,000 is enough for this kind of investment. So kinalculate ko yung odds. Sabi ko, it just 6 months. 6 months lang naman naantayin ko para makakuha na ako nito. Pero by that, yung mga time na yon, hindi ako na contento sa 6 months, eh. Gusto ko yung mga one year or 2 years na patulog na sinasabi nila na, which is aabot ng million. But it just happened that for after 3 months, 4 months, 5 months na actually yun, biglang nag-collapse. Then it deteriorates my psychological health. And at some point of time, I kept thinking that it may be the reason why I became anxious at that time. So naapektuhan yung health ko nung mga time na yun. Pero sabi ko sa isip ko, risk taker, naging risk taker rin naman ako dati. Pero iba yung mga time na yun. Hindi ko rin kasi mabiblame kung yun ba yung dahilan or masyadong naging stressful yung mga nangyari sa akin nung last year. So double kill yung nangyari, which is wala akong nakuhang reward, wala akong nakuhang blessing dun sa na-donate ko. At the same time, binabayaran ko yung utang ko, which is almost 100,000 na binabayaran ko with interest. So I end up, at some time, I became depressed, but mabilis lang yung recovery. 3 months lang na naka-recover na ako. It was a very powerful lesson for me that I had this realization at that moment na the importance of loan are crucial. the importance of role of have making a loan or pursuing a loan is important. So you will only use this loan in a project you like, on a passion or investment that you believe, you really believe you can take the risk or you can have the gut, or to spend only what you can afford or invest only what you can afford to lose.